Good morning, everyone. My name is Ramya and my advisor is Professor Grace Gao. I'm a PhD student at University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign and a visiting student at Stanford. Today, the topic of my presentation is on integrity-driven landmark attention for GPS vision navigation via stochastic reachability. As we are all aware, sensor fusion increases data redundancy by combining measurements from complementary sensors such as GPS and vision. However, in urban areas, large data does not always ensure high accuracy. This is because GPS and vision suffer from measurement faults. In particular, GPS faults occur due to multipath effects, while vision faults occur due to data association errors across images. Therefore, there is a need for integrity-driven sensor fusion that accounts for multiple faults in both GPS and vision. Integrity is defined as the measure of trust in the correctness of estimated position. The integrity measures of interest to us at position error bounds and system availability. In this context, alert limit is the prescribed maximum position error beyond which the system is declared unavailable. While there has been a significant research on localization using GPS and vision, there is limited prior work that addresses the integrity aspect. The existing works can be classified into three categories: probabilistic approaches, aided GPS techniques, and analysis of multi-fault hypotheses. In probabilistic approaches, faults are detected and isolated by analyzing the distribution of measurement residuals. However, separate methodologies are required to model the faults in GPS and vision. Furthermore, fault exclusion can cause poor dilution of precision. Secondly, the research on aided GPS techniques utilize vision data to detect GPS faults but do not account for faults in vision itself. A different line of research evaluates multi-fault hypotheses but requires an upper bound on the number of faults to avoid combinatorial explosion. To address the shortcomings of existing approaches, the objectives of this work are to select measurements from GPS and vision that minimize position error bounds, design a unified approach to address multiple faults in GPS and vision while ensuring computational tractability, compute integrity measures of expected navigation performance. To meet the objectives, we derive inspiration from the cognitive processes of human brain. Essentially, what do we as humans do while navigating? For this, let's look at an example. With the start of a new quarter, there are lots of new students on campus. A student asks you the directions to go from Stanford Oval, marked by blue arrow, to Bites Cafe, marked in magenta. In this context, how does the student execute your instructions to reach Bites Cafe? To navigate, the student essentially relies on different sensory cues, sometimes visual like street name, stop sign, and sometimes others like smell of the food, are loud chatting sounds, and so on. Furthermore, given the limited computational resources of the brain, the student may also ignore some other cues like clouds, any malfunctioning road signs, other people on the street, and so on. Therefore, at each instant, the student navigates by giving attention to certain aspects in the surroundings while filtering out the irrelevant or faulty ones. Drawing parallels, the core idea of this work is to develop integrity-driven landmark attention. For this, we define two terms. One is landmark and the other is attention. Landmarks are the features in the surroundings used for navigation. We define two types of landmarks. First are GPS satellites, whose locations are known from ephemeris. Second are the 3D visual features, whose locations are unknown and need to be triangulated. The next term is attention, which we define as the process of parsing large data from GPS and vision to select landmarks that maximize the integrity-driven performance under limited compute capability. To understand what we mean by maximizing integrity-driven performance, let's look at the illustration shown in this slide. In both the figures, the blue blob denotes the safety alert limit. The diamonds denote the landmarks, and their measurement quality is indicated by gradient of colors from blue to yellow, with blue indicating low fault magnitude and yellow indicating high. In case one, the selected landmarks exhibit poor DOP, high faults, and therefore violate the safety alert limit. Whereas case two shows a desirable subset of landmarks that exclude the necessary faults and satisfy the alert limit conditions. Essentially, we estimate a binary decision for each landmark that indicates whether it is to be included or excluded for GPS vision localization. The outline of the presentation is seen in this slide. I will first explain our proposed algorithm on integrity-driven landmark attention, in short known as ILA, and its different modules. Next, I will demonstrate the performance and robustness of our ILA technique using experimental data. In the end, I will summarize my talk. To start off, let's look at the main design aspects of our integrity-driven landmark attention, in short known as ILA. To select the subset of informative landmarks among the available ones, we opt for an optimization framework. In particular, we relax the binary constraints on each landmark and formulate a convex total cost that maximizes the number of landmarks utilized while jointly minimizing the position error bounds. This brings us to our second design aspect, which is cost formulation using stochastic reachability. We formulate position error bounds in set value domain as a union function across included landmarks. As seen in the figure, a set-valued approach propagates not only the point-valued mean of state, but also its set-valued bounds. This only requires the measurement error bounds in non-faulty conditions. Finally, the third aspect is that our ILA technique works with any off-the-shelf GPS vision localization module and follows a unified approach to account for both GPS and vision faults. Our current work is inspired by a set-valued formulation designed for stochastic processes known as stochastic reachability, which is widely used in robotics for path planning. It computes a set of stochastic reachable states given an initial set and known error bounds. In this context, we parameterize the stochastic reachable set using a set representation called probabilistic zonotope, in short, p-zonotope. An example of a p-zonotope is shown in the slide. A p-zonotope is an enclosed probabilistic hull that collectively captures the non-Gaussian and time-varying nature of measurement errors. The p-zonotopes are characterized by three parameters, which are also pointed out in the figure. Center is indicated in red, width in green, and covariance in blue. The key contributions of this work are that we develop a modular integrity-driven landmark attention for GPS vision navigation that performs optimization via convex relaxation to compute a subset of informative landmarks, formulate p-zonotopic cost using stochastic reachability to account for multiple faults in both GPS and vision, predicts integrity measures, that is error bounds and availability, for a given safety alert limit. This figure shows the architecture of the integrity-driven landmark attention technique. During initialization, we perform an offline empirical analysis to compute the measurement error bounds of GPS and vision in non-faulty case. Later, at each time instant, we consider the measurements obtained from GPS and vision along with the known motion model as inputs. We utilize measurement history to formulate the p-zonotopic cost that represents the size of set-valued position bounds as a function of landmark inclusion or exclusion. Thereafter, we jointly optimize the p-zonotopic cost and number of landmarks via convex relaxation to estimate a subset of informative landmarks and the predicted measure of system availability. The selected landmarks are later given to any off-the-shelf GPS vision localization module. In the upcoming slides, I will explain the two modules of ILM in more detail. Firstly, utilizing the linearized measurement model and their known error bounds, we compute the p-zonotope of expected states for each landmark. Next, we perform a set union operation of these p-zonotopes to estimate the overall position error bounds, which is represented by an over-approximated p-zonotope. The figure on the left shows an example of p-zonotopes of expected 2D position from three landmarks. And the figure on the right shows the set union of these p-zonotopes by an over-approximated p-zonotope. The set union depicts a conservative upper bound and therefore accounts for estimation error associated with any off-the-shelf GPS vision localization. However, an important point to note here is that this formulation considers the measurement errors to lie within the offline estimated measurement error bounds. But this is not the case during the presence of faults. To account for measurement faults, we leverage the stochastic nature of p-zonotopes. The p-zonotope of landmark measurement bounds is illustrated in the figure and is indicative of errors in non-faulty conditions. For each landmark, we independently analyze the received measurements against the measurement error bounds to compute its fault status. The fault status lies between 0 to 1, with 0 being most likely faulty and 1 indicating it is non-faulty. Particularly, we utilize measurement time history to compute a cumulative fault status that is indicative of the temporal confidence in the landmark. This also satisfies the need of temporal measurements of a visual landmark to triangulate its unknown position. Next, we utilize the inverse of estimated fault status for each landmark to scale the size of non-faulty measurement error bounds. Intuitively, to minimize the position bounds using set union, landmarks with low fault status are more desirable. The over-approximated p-zonotope estimated from set union is a linear function of attention set Q. This attention set comprises of binary variables associated with each GPS and vision landmark, and its value is to be estimated later via optimization. Next, given a cutoff threshold, we represent the over-approximated p-zonotope by a polygon Z of Q, which is indicated in the figure by magenta box. Next, we formulate the scalar p-zonotopic cost denoted by F of Q that represents the size of the set valued polygon, which is given by the sum of weighted eigenvalues along each axis. Now, as seen in the equation, we formulate the total convex cost by jointly minimizing the p-zonotopic cost that indicates lower size of position bounds and maximizing the number of landmarks that indicate higher confidence in the associated position bounds. As explained earlier, to formulate a convex cost, we relax the binary constraints on the attention set, that is, instead of either 0, which indicates exclusion, or 1, which indicates inclusion, they lie in a continuous domain between 0 and 1. We optimize the total cost using standard optimization solvers to compute attention set that is later rounded to select the subset of informative landmarks. In addition, the value of p-zonotopic cost for the estimated attention set provides predicted position bounds. By comparing this predicted bound against alert limit, we estimate the system availability. Now, I will talk about our experimental results that validate the performance of the proposed integrity-driven landmark attention technique. For experimental validation, we consider an urban sequence from TU Munich monocular camera data set. We pre-process the images via direct image alignment to obtain the key features. The figure shows the trajectory visualization of an experimental duration of 60 seconds. We generated simulated GPS data and randomly induced measurement faults of magnitude 20 to 65 meters between t equal to 9 to 24 seconds. We utilized Cora toolbox to implement stochastic reachability and CVX to perform convex optimization. Based on the urban setting, we considered the prescribed safety alert limit to be 7.5 meters. In the first set of results, we demonstrate the improved localization accuracy via the proposed ILA technique as compared to the landmarks selected using other approaches. The black line indicates that only GPS landmarks are used for localization. Magenta indicates all GPS and vision landmarks. Orange indicates random selection with number of landmarks that match our ILA technique. For random selection, we ran 300 Monte Carlo runs and plotted the minimum exhibited position error at each instant. Also for reference, the red dashed line indicates the alert limit of 7.5 meters. The off-the-shelf localization module we utilized in this work is our prior work on graph optimization-based GPS vision SLAM. During the time t equal to 9 to 24 seconds, that represents a narrow alleyway with repetitive visual features and simulated multipath effects, multiple faults occur in both GPS and vision. The proposed ILA technique demonstrates high localization accuracy with a maximum error of only 6.6 meters as compared to other techniques that violate alert limit with max position errors exceeding 13 meters. In this slide, for a time instant t equal to 54 seconds, we compare the statistics of accuracy and the number of landmarks across different techniques. As compared to other methods, a low accuracy of 2.9 meters is achieved using our ILA technique that selects 6 out of 8 GPS landmarks and 956 out of 4,722 visual landmarks. These selected landmarks in GPS and vision are shown in the figures on the right. In addition, our ILA technique successfully bounds the estimated position error by predicting the position error bounds to be 5.1 meters, and therefore the system is predicted to be available. Extending this, in the next set of results, we plot the predicted availability to analyze the robustness of our ILA technique. With a safety alert limit of 7.5 meters, the predicted availability of 1 indicates that the predicted position bounds are less than alert limit, and 0 indicates otherwise. We observe that the proposed ILA provides a robust measure of predicted availability, with the system being available for 98.24% of the entire time duration. To summarize, in this work, we developed a modular integrity-driven landmark attention for GPS vision navigation that performs optimization via convex relaxation by selecting the subset of most informative landmarks from GPS satellites and 3D visual features. We formulate p-zonotopic cost using stochastic reachability via set-valued position bounds that account for both GPS and vision faults. Through experiments, we validated the improved localization accuracy and robust prediction of system availability. We want to thank the members of NavLab for all the insightful discussions. Thank you, and I will be happy to answer any questions.